Oh, rush through. You'll be good. She'll vamp on as you continue. Don't worry about it, okay? All righty. So I want to warn you that our next hymn, it's incorrect in the bulletin. So look up on the bulletin on the board here. It's going to be number 583 in the black, okay? The next hymn after the sermon is number 583. So you may want to grab that now so you don't mess up later, okay? 583 in the black. Alrighty, my friends, so today's message, I don't know if you really were paying attention to that, but there was a Jesus in the middle of this sermon here, or in this middle of this this event, got a little testy. You remember what he said? You go tell that fox. You guys can have a seat. We're done right now, okay? You go tell that fox. Do you ever recall Jesus saying that? Pretty cool, huh? Jesus gets out on there, right? He gets up and he gets in their faces. He doesn't really isn't getting their faces. He's getting in Herod's face. Okay, so the reason why he said that, you know, and I don't blame him, is if you paid attention to the reading, these Pharisees had come to him. And whatever their intentions were, they had their different intentions, I'm sure, than what we might think. But they had said to him, they said, because Jesus was there doing his thing. And the Pharisees said, Jesus, watch out, Herod is out for your head. So they were warning him. He was coming after Jesus. And if somebody said, if you were doing something and you were, it could be doing something charitable, you could be feeding people, doing a spaghetti dinner on a Friday night, coming here to worship and learning how to take care of things in the world in a way that is equitable and just and right. And somebody walks in the back door over there, and they bust in here, and they say, hey, somebody is coming with guns blazing. What you gonna do? Well, you know, that is the strategy, friends. Because we need to rest a moment to think about what happened 2 days ago in New Zealand. Guns came a-blazing for what and who they are, for their faith. We rest a moment at this very moment to remember those people. Let us rest. Amen. The strategy, that is the strategy, by the way, if something happens, you know, is run, right? Hide. And in essence, at the end, if you have no other way, fight. Okay? So I'm going to tell you that right now. That's what everyone is being told to do in case of a situation like that. Run, hide, fight. Now, Jesus was in this situation, though he was being given warning. And Jesus didn't run, and instead, he decided to get downright defiant. You go tell that fox. You're basically telling him off. You know? You're not going to scare me. Well, should he have been scared? Yes, exactly. So, you know, I'm sure that Jesus was scared. Who wouldn't be? He was still human, despite the fact of us tossing all this divinity upon the man and all this confidence. He was still a human. All right? He had to have been afraid. But He chose to be quite confrontational. So, you know, when he said, you know, you go tell that fox whatever, 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 you know, he knew that anybody who came to Jerusalem, by the way, you see, that was the whole story he was trying to say. Hey, I can go to Jerusalem anytime. Prophets have been killed there time and time and time again in the past. Okay? I know the history. I know what I'm up against. But you know, I think Jesus was being a little bit vulnerable in this whole thing as well. I mean, he had to have been. He had to have been vulnerable to the feelings of everything. But at the same time, I think he must have felt that he had no choice but to be bold. I don't know. I have to ask you, do you think you could have been as bold? I want to ask you that question. Do you think that you could be as bold? Barb's shaking her head. Absolutely not. I could not be so bold. Anybody else? Anyone else who agrees I could not be so bold as to do that? Hands going up. Exactly. All right. Show me all the courageous ones. Who would have done something? Who would have said, you go tell that fox? Anybody? Ah, interesting. Ah, Jane says, it depends if I would have done it. If, who do I have for support? Denise, you have anything else to add about that?
You don't know until you're in that situation.
Hmm. You don't know until you're in the situation. Yeah. You know, because he could have, you know, I don't know. I can't read Jesus' mind. You know, was he just reacting? Was he just mad? Did he have, you know, some courage out of the blue? Or was he realizing, you know, that it didn't really matter? He had nothing to lose, Jeff says. Yeah, could have been that situation. He had nothing to lose. Well, okay, so if you have nothing to lose and you challenge or you confront the powers that be or the powers that are not really our power but are danger, you know, you wouldn't want to taunt terrorism, would you? No. Okay. So his confrontation in this situation, and Jane and has said something about it depends on whose support you've got. So what support did Jesus have?
All his followers. If he ran, what happened to the followers?
So Rick says all his followers. And so if he ran, what about his followers? So Rick is suggesting that he knew he had a mission. He needed to stand up for something. And that if he didn't, who was? Anybody else feel that bold? All right. So, you know, I don't know if you're ever going to be up against something that is so endangering to you in your life. However, I do know that we will at times in our lives feel endangered in some way. It may not be for our life. What other ways could we be come after? People could come after us. What other ways do you feel people could come after you and you be frightened or threatened? For what would you be threatened of losing? Okay, it could just be about your opinion. What else could you be threatened by? Paula?
They steal your money.
They could take your money. What else?
Liberty.
They could take your liberty. What else?
They
could take your cell phone. Oh my goodness. Hey, all right, here, you can have it. Lindsay?
Your family.
Yes. You could fear that they're after your family or to endanger them. What else? Daniel, did you have something or no? No. Your reputation. What's that? Yep, reputation as well down here. Your status as a Christian. So tell me a little bit more about that.
Someone is telling you you're not welcome in this congregation.
Oh.
That your lifestyle or your decisions make you a sinner.
Your people could come after you to say, no, you don't. You're not a Christian because of who you are or because of your lifestyle. We have stood out against that, my friends. And I'm going to tell you right now, people came at us about it. All right? But you stayed on. You stayed the course. We are a place that accepts and believes in all persons as children of God. Bottom line, amen. Anything else you can think of? All right. So it's not always your bodily harm, your end of life issues that you might want to be fearful of, that people coming after you. It could just be about your person, who you are, your reputation, your safety, your sense of freedom, your sense of just being a human being. And it can be very, very, very frightening. So, how do we, as believers, as simple human beings then, how do we find perhaps the courage, and sometimes people might say the stupidity, to say, you go tell that fox? How does one do such a thing, and what motivation would bring us to be able to do that? Well, yes, Paula. I'm going to have to feel very strongly. Yep. It's going to have to be a courage that's rooted very deep down. Rooted in something that you are unwilling to compromise upon. Okay? And that you are willing to stand for, that you are willing to literally go up against anything. Jesus has led us and encourages us then to lead in the same manner. I don't think he wanted us to put ourselves in harm's way, unless, of course, that is our choice and we feel strongly enough about it. And especially, as Rick had pointed out, he did it not just for himself. He did it for those who would follow him, those whom he was befriended to, those people who as well loved God and loved what was right. This is a very difficult decision to take. And we know that people have, over the centuries, lived and died in those cases, in those scenarios. It is not as expected of everybody. But there are lesser things, like I said, maybe not end-of-life issues that at times may force us to do that. But there are moments when all of a sudden we feel threatened. We feel threatened, and all of a sudden we want to fold. And we don't think we can carry on and carry the message of hope or justice or peace or whatever it is. I pray again that you hold dear that you're not alone, especially in places of justice and hope and in peace. Hold strong, for God is with you. I am with you. The person I pray next to you is with you, and that your lives and all lives are made better because of your choice to hold firm. Amen, and I thank you for Jesus' message.